What is up, Midway Mayhem fans? This is Dan, and we are back here at the Universal Orlando Resort for opening day for the Toothsome Chocolate Emporium and Savory Feast Kitchen. Let's head over and check it out. Out with the old and in with the new. The new sign does say now open for preview.
Woohoo! The restaurant will be open at 4. Only the foundry is open at 11.
So we are officially going in. Are you excited?
I'm excited.
Super excited.
Much excited.
Wow. Much excited. Come on. We know how to operate doors. And voila. We are inside Toothsome. Yeah, it is gorgeous. Awesome AC system in here.
6 2 9 1 5.
When your cocoa beans are spinning and this giant pipe goes all the way down, but very neat.
What's in the marshmallow crisp?
So the marshmallow crisp milkshake is a vanilla-based milkshake, so it's vanilla ice cream, and then we put a Rice Krispie treat in it. We're topping on top a marshmallow and another Rice Krispie treat on top for the shake.
I think I'll do that.
The marshmallow.
That sounds amazing.
And this is your table. Make sure you set it this side down on a table before you shake it out.
Okay, awesome.
And I'm going to put it under the same poster number.
Alrighty guys, so I'm about to order right now, and I'm going to get the salted delish, I think it is. That one's got the pretzels on it, so I'm going to do that. And here's the awesome thing. If you are a pass holder, you actually get a discount. So go ahead and use the pass, and look how much it actually takes off. So check this out. So $1.88 comes off of that. So definitely use your pass.
It comes off to $11.32.
Woohoo. Not a bad deal.
No. Especially for all that you're getting.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Alright, so after you make your order, they give you this little tracker and you actually place it down on the table. So it's place tracker on table and everything else. It'll be a buzzer to let you know when your order is ready. So we're gonna go sit down and wait for it.
I'm excited.
We got the salted, and then we also got the marshmallow.
Delicious.
So we have our volunteer right here. This is actually the official wardrobe for Toothsome. Very nice looking, and it feels that steampunk look. And of course, we have Penelope here somewhere. And hopefully
we'll be making an appearance soon.
And we should be seeing her soon, but I love the outfit. It looks fantastic.
Thank you. I love the other folks that have the actual gear, like the leather.
Have you had a chance to try any of the drinks or no? What's your favorite one?
Honestly, I like the peanut pie, peanut butter delicious is the closest.
Yeah, that would be the other one that I wanted to get. I wanted to get the nice fancy looking one first. When I come back, I'm definitely going to be getting that.
That
would
be
just
coming and try them all and see
what's
your favorite.
Thank you, Miss. So check this out, guys. Doesn't that look absolutely delicious? All the different ice creams that they have here. Gentlemen scooping out some right now. And of course, here are some of the drinks already on the way out. Very excited for this, guys.
Look at this. Just look at this.
That's the marshmallow crisp one. So it's got this giant marshmallow as well as a Rice Krispie treat on it. We've got the Toothsome logo right there. This glass itself is actually plastic. So it's not glass, actually. So
it looks like glass.
It looks like
and
glass.
And you can take it home.
Yeah, so that's actually a souvenir. So when you buy your milkshake, you can take that home. So both drinks are now here. Check out this. So we have the pretzels, the salted delish, and amazing looking, and I think it's time. I think it's time, sir.
I think so, too.
I think we need to put away the menus. We
yes.
need to Let's get ready to prepare and indulge on this. So, yeah, I have already indulged in over half of this drink. It is beyond amazing. It is very salty, but it's not salty. The caramel balances it perfectly. The drink itself, you can actually drink it with a straw. So you have the option to do either a spoon or a straw, but you can drink it with a straw. Brandon's, again, same thing. Texture was amazing. The Rice Krispies throughout were very nice.
Yep.
And again, you can drink it or do a spoon. But yeah, we're gonna enjoy some more of this. So we pretty much got ourselves in a diabetic coma.
Yeah, we had the shakes.
So I think we should try to really push for it and see how much chocolate we can find in the gift shop. And you guys know I love gift shops. And right off the bat, they have some really neat merchandise in here. So that shirt right there. They have lollipops with chocolate on them.
We have covered marshmallows. This one is
it's got to be an arm and a leg, right? You're talking an arm and a leg for this thing.
No, not even that. $3.95.
Can't go with your there. Discount, you get a discount with
That's
your pass.
15% off on a premium.
Very nice. So we're going to do a tour here of the gift shop. Of course, we have more chocolate bars over here. This is bark, looks like.
Yep.
Milk chocolate gourmet bark.
With something in it, like
nuts, something like that.
Nuts, raisins.
Yeah. What's on the price for this one?
$12.95.
So again, not bad for this. More merchandise for the shirt there. And of course, let's walk around, see what else we got.
Bark everywhere.
Dark chocolate. More t-shirts over here.
White chocolate on the other side.
White chocolate over here. So yeah, whatever you want to suit your flavor, taste buds.
And
they've got it.
If you want fresh chocolate. It's
what
right
is this?
There.
This looks interesting. What? Look at this. Look at this thing. That is a white chocolate swan. Look at the design on that thing, though.
That's incredible.
So they have like this little kitchen area, and there's even a chocolate machine over here, which is pouring and stirring in chocolate right there. So it's going to town on that. But they have what looks to be almost like brittle. Over here?
Yeah. Fudge.
Fudge.
Something.
Yep. And then more crazy designs that we have. This is a clock structure, and this is all made from chocolate. Everything. All of this is chocolate. I wonder how much that thing costs. What do you think?
It's easily
I don't think,
digits.
I would say,
easily.
I don't think that's going to be $12.
No, no.
I think that's a little bit more advanced.
That might be that arm and a leg.
Yeah. And then again, another cog. Cogs everywhere all over this place, but it's not even that. Look at on the nut right there. Again, attention to detail. Crazy.
That's an actual nut.
I think it's all chocolate.
Yeah.
This is all chocolate. And they have a conveyor belt right there, of course. And then check out the design on this thing. That's pretty intricate.
That is. That makes me wonder, how are they keeping it up?
I don't know.
It has to be really cold in there.
I would say so. Or, I don't know, chocolate around 70 degrees, I'm sure is fine. Anything over 70 is probably too hot.
Yeah.
But those are some crazy designs. Shall we continue on to the rest of the gift shop?
We shall.
All right, so let's head over to some other areas of the gift shop. And see
might
what else we have.
More of a chocolate coma, but...
Yes. So, we have s'mores. What is this? We didn't see this.
Marshmallows. S'mores marshmallows.
Huh.
That's only... It's only $9.95 for that box. It's not bad. And it's heavy, too.
And then we have a Penelope Toothsome shirt. I don't think that would look good on you, sir.
No.
No, I don't think that'll work.
Back, but not yeah.
I don't think that works. But the coffee mugs are really awesome. And let's see, these are probably, what, right around the $12 mark?
14. So $15
not
for this.
Not the same as in the parks.
Yeah, not the same as in the parks. That one I like.
I like this one, and the material is super, super soft.
You see that? You see what that sticker says? No two shirts are exactly alike.
Yeah.
What?
Interesting.
Very interesting. And then we have something in this bottle here. It looks like a flask, but it's candy.
And it's actually a glass bottle too. So yeah. You're getting
it looks old. Heavy.
$14.95 also. So okay. Mug or a glass flask.
And then this is what I've been waiting for, right over here. We have the chocolate bars. So we have dark chocolate. You have your regular chocolate, white chocolate. See, there's white chocolate. And then these interesting little things look like elixirs. What is this?
It is sour cherry candy powder.
So it's a powder.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, it's powder.
And it's only, it has no price on it.
Oh, it's free.
No. Oh, there we go. $9.95.
Okay, $9.95 for that. But again, this is what I'm really interested in, is these chocolate bars. And speaking of these chocolate bars, if you guys want one of these, we are having a contest where if you share this video with the hashtag Midway Mayhem, we will give you one of these if you are selected as our winner. And we may have more than one winner, but again, if you share this video, hashtag Midway Mayhem, we'll be able to actually find out whether or not you did share it or not. But one of you guys is gonna walk away with a Toothsome Chocolate Emporium chocolate bar.
Of your choosing.
Of your choosing. So white chocolate, dark chocolate, whatever. And then, what? Craziness. They have some really awesome stuff here, man. I don't know what else
time
to say.
It is.
It's chocolate time. That's what time it is. That is a chocolate watch.
And it
and
gets,
you can eat it. Eat me.
And you know, the key to my heart is through more chocolate. Just
and
saying.
It is a chocolate key. That's crazy. And just in case you want to put a lock on it, they do have locks. So chocolate locks, and then what's this down here? A bottle cap and bottle opener.
You might need that.
Yes.
You might need that
and
with all the chocolate.
Looks like
out.
We have a wine opener here, like a corkscrew.
I know plenty of people who can use that.
Now, it does look like this is a third party one, though.
Yeah,
so
it's a Chocolat.
Yeah, Chocolat.
Handmade in Britain.
Okay. So we have British chocolate here on top of the Toothsome chocolate that we have.
That stuff is only going. Now, this is where we're going a little higher. $19.95. But remember, if you have an annual pass, you can definitely
and
save a little bit.
But here's the thing, I can see them actually trying to push more or less their chocolates.
Yep.
So a third party chocolate I would expect to be more expensive. So yeah,
yep.
That's right about the lines that we're looking at. So let's continue on over here.
We have peanut
popcorn.
Butter drizzle popcorn.
Peanut butter drizzle. So it's like caramel popcorn in a sense.
$8.95.
It's reasonable.
Yeah. And we also have Toothsome Airship number 9, whatever that flavor is.
No clue. But it looks like it's got white chocolate in there, see?
Yeah. We got all sorts of stuff. Emporium Drizzle, they have a few different flavors.
Yeah. More of those keys and locks. And then they have some really neat artifacts here. Check this out. All of these merchandise items right here, you can actually take home with you. So they have skulls. This neat little kind of like crow mask aviator. And then check out that mask. That's really kind of neat.
And
what's this?
We have a little steampunk windmill.
Steampunk windmill. That does spin.
And
What's that? Whoa, it actually has almost like a little hideaway there.
Store more chocolate.
Yep, store more chocolate. And that one is $48.95. But again, all these little items here you can take home with you if you so choose. $100 for
that's
this neat
amazing.
Little... That's a crazy clock. It's a lot of attention to detail on that. Hot air balloon, of course. Another clock right there. And then I like this actually. Bookshelf ends. You mind pulling that down real quick? So we can get a better look. And it's got what, almost like a velvet
yeah,
on the other side of it?
It's very soft, protects your books. We got cogs down here and a propeller. Same ones, just made in China. It's not bad.
So yeah, very neat. Let's walk over here and check out some of the other items that we have. So there's this octopus looking thing. Yeah. So that is the octopus secret trinket box. I'm not gonna try to see where that trinket is. Even though I see a little cable over here, like a chain, so probably somewhere over there. But I'd rather not break it and have to pay for something that I'm not ultimately gonna own. And then we have submarine, diver helmets,
monkey.
The monkey. It's Kong! I found Kong! this shoe. I know ladies like the shoes. Mm-hmm. I don't think you could wear that one though.
Maybe even.
But that's a neat mirror.
Hand mirror.
Say hello.
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 More bookshelf fins. Again, the hot air balloons, the skull. All over the place. All right, so we covered those. Let's head into the back of the gift shop to see what else we have. And it is quite busy in here for the first day. What do we have over here?
Raspberry lime gourmet lollipops.
Lollipops?
Lollipops with raspberries. So it's lime flavored lollipops with raspberries in them.
Very neat.
That's neat.
And I see something over there. I love chocolate for the bag.
That would do good on a long day at the park. Yeah. Put your souvenir bottle in there. Yeah.
Now, this shirt looks really neat. I wouldn't mind doing something like that.
Yeah, and the material's super soft. This would be good on even a hot day.
Yeah, but the only thing that I will note, though, is, of course, you probably want to turn that inside out whenever you wash it. I'd be afraid
to dry it.
Yeah, I'd be afraid that you may lose some of that.
It's iron on.
It's a beautiful shirt regardless. But just take care with it, I'm sure.
Yeah.
They have more of the lollipops over here.
What do we got here?
Different flavors now.
Raspberry and maki? M-A-Q-U-I, whatever that is.
Okay. Alrighty. Whatever it may be.
Very exotic.
Yeah.
As with a lot of the things here.
And then check this out. We have candy floss.
And look at this.
Big old display, and it's got the different flavors too.
Got knobs.
It looks like it's functioning, but of course it is for display.
That's
and then we
awesome.
Have the gumball dispenser. What kind of flavors do we have here?
Well, we got, looks like it might be like a mint or something. Absinthe.
What?
Absinthe.
Absinthe?
Absinthe. Let's try to find another flavor. We have
something that we actually know.
Peanut butter and jelly.
All right, that one I would actually
that one I
want.
Would probably go for. Yeah. We got another one here. Chocolate espresso for the coffee lovers.
Yes. I see a strawberry rose petal here. Blackberry lavender.
Orange vanilla cream. Yes, please.
Yes, please. I see a lot of orange vanilla cream. Blue vanilla.
Right no here. Way.
What is this?
Cookies and cream. And there's actual cookies
that's
and
awesome.
Oreos in there. Huh. Wow.
There's that PB&J. There's the chocolate espresso.
Blue vanilla,
yeah.
Wow. Lots
so a lot of different selections here. And again, more of those popcorn things over there.
And the thing about this place, the prices are amazing. They're no. low. They're reasonable. If you have kids and you have the one thing to buy them, take them here. This is the ultimate candy shop.
Yeah, it really is. And this caught my eye because it looks
it's
like
shiny.
Alcohol.
It's shiny.
It looks like a liquor bottle, but
it's more of that sour cherry. It's liquid though. It's not a powder.
Okay, so we have sour cherry. What's some other flavors that we have?
Looks like we got some blue one here. We got sour blueberry.
Okay, so anything in these seems like it's going to be a sour.
Yeah, sour watermelon.
Yep.
So pucker up.
Yep. And then
sour pineapple.
So pineapple, cherry, all sorts of things. There's more of that powder candy right there. So we have a sour raspberry candy powder.
These bottles are just, they look
well,
amazing.
You can collect them and put them around your house. I think that's pretty neat. In fact, we have more of these bottles right over here.
Got rock candy.
Rock candy.
Blueberry rock crystal candy. So if you're not into the sours, but you want the bottle, there you go.
That's neat. More powdered over here. So salted caramel, chocolate strawberry, rim sugar, key lime pie.
Choco Rocks!
Choco
we got
rocks.
Choco Rocks!
Woo. And again, blue, green. They have small versions like up here and then the larger kind of size over here.
Any color that fits your fancy?
Yes. And then all the dispensers right here, we have chocolate covered cashews, blackberry chocolate, almonds, berries, bean mix, chocolate rocks, silver rocks, all sorts of stuff. Brandon has a bag over here.
So it looks like you can fill the bag.
So you can do that option, but I also see there's this option right here where you can get a neat little souvenir.
Has a little seal chocolate emporium right there.
What's the price on this one?
That is $9.95. Now, I'm not too sure if that includes this. But
I don't think so. So I think that includes the jar, and then you can fill it up with whatever you'd like inside here. So, of course, we have the almonds, orange peel, blueberries, chocolate cherries, sunflower seeds, chocolate rocks again, Irish chocolate mocha beans, sea salt caramels, and purple chocolate covered malt balls. Absolutely crazy.
Getting the shakes again.
Yeah. And then this is pretty neat. This goes up to the second story, but it's a staircase with what looks to be some trinkets and whatnot from Penelope's travels from around the world.
Books. Jules Verne, right there. Yep. Journey to the Center of the Earth.
And then over here, monocle. Does that fit? Let's see.
No.
But I do see some other neat merchandise. Of course, this shirt right here.
You mentioned Kong. This reminds me of Kong.
That does. I actually like that. That looks very nice on you, actually.
And it fits very well, too. So.
Yes. I see some other hats over here.
Oh, boy. Okay. Polar hats?
Nah, not so much.
No. How about you try a hat on?
I will try a hat in just a second if I can get this camera over to you.
Let's see. Does it fit?
Nah.
I got too big of a head.
Yeah.
But let's see. If I don't want to do that, I can always go on a safari like Jumanji here.
Jumanji!
Yes?
That,
no?
I actually think that works.
Imagine walking around the park with this hat. It'd be pretty funny.
You might not be so out of the place.
Yeah. But again, we have more of the chocolate candies here. A ladies' t-shirt right here. I love chocolate.
Who doesn't?
Yeah. Lots of ladies' apparel. Again, more of the Penelope Toothsome shirts. And then check this out. We have a whole bunch of jewelry that's actually in place. So they have cuffs, necklaces, they have rings as well.
I gotta say, that one right there might be my personal favorite. The Cloud Pilot Sextant Pendant.
Yeah.
That is amazing.
So we have that. We also have some other stuff up here at the top. Again, all of this is for purchase.
And I wanted to show off these. The earrings as well look very, very neat. Have the key cogs on there. More of those shirts. I definitely don't think that's gonna fit you.
I don't think it fits me.
It's like a Charlie Chaplin hat for you. Bags, other hats, Darby's. I'm really in love with that clock. So yeah, shirts everywhere. But that's gonna do it, at least for the merchandise. Let's go check over here and see what they have when it comes to truffles. So they have, let's see, bourbon, absinthe, mint chocolate.
Bourbon, please.
Yeah, key lime pie. I mean, literally all sorts. But check this out.
What?
Whoa. But look how intricate the design is. So it's like.
It's a chocolate shot.
Yeah. And then this right here, it's. What are these things?
What are those?
What are these? They're like cupcakes, but I would assume you like. Cut into it?
It's like a lava cake.
Oh, okay. So when you actually
like falls apart, it has that molded chocolate in it.
So they have a white chocolate cheesecake as well. They tropical fruit.
Pretty.
Yeah. Definitely put into detail on this. And then, see how that. Orange vanilla cream. Red velvet gourmet cupcake. And more of those cogs, and in fact, those are giant cogs right there. We have some other chocolate.
Looks like we have a cookies and cream one, chocolate chip, vanilla drizzle. It all looks amazing. We got, what was that, orange? Chocolate dipped orange.
Yeah, and then strawberries.
Strawberries.
The pineapple.
All sorts of stuff. Anything that'll fit your fancy, yeah. Basically.
And let's go over here and check out some other stuff. So here's the checkout area. They also have mints.
Ooh.
And then the last area that we're going to check out is right over here. They have a whole bunch of truffles, things like that. A flavor reference card. So these are all the different ones that you can get. See, banana rum, whiskey, Irish cream, peanut butter crunch. Now let's enough of that. Let's go to talk about it.
Macaroons.
Yes. And these you can actually buy by individual. So you can buy one or you can buy it as a box as well. But they have birthday cake, lemon blueberry, lots of different flavors.
More of that PB&J right there.
PB&J would be pretty awesome. And then of course there are the chocolate cogs, a better view. They have smaller ones. And they also have the larger ones right here.
They have cogs within cogs.
Yes. And then it looks like we have some brittle or bark. Yep.
Let me see how much it is first.
So, and then here's more of the truffles and things like that. Look at this. Look at that. Zoom in if you can on that. That's got a mustache.
Sorry, sir, I must ask you a question.
So, I believe from what I was told, these are hand-painted or airbrushed on.
Yeah.
Every single one of them.
Lots of attention to detail goes in. A lot of time, a lot of effort.
Yeah, look at the different, like... These are incredible, though. I've never seen chocolates like this kind of...
Look at this one. Pecan patty. Cherry liqueur cheesecake. Yes, please. Cinnamon habanero if you're feeling a little spicy. And then look at this, guys. We have little trinkets.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
More souvenirs all over the place that you can take home. So far, I gotta say, I think the gift shop looks absolutely amazing. I wanna go check out what the dinner service looks like, though, in the dining area. Let's go take a look. All right, so let's take a look at the dinner service area. So this is the lower level, and right off the bat, we can see tables look beautiful. Chairs themselves, they look nice. A big wide open area, and you can look all the way up to the ceiling. So this is a very tall ceiling in here. We do have some screens over here with a very steampunk look. And then check it out, a full bar service right here. They don't have all the liquor in there just yet, but as soon as we actually get closer to the 4 p.m. mark, I'm sure they're gonna have bottles all over the place. We do have, of course, tap right here with Guinness, Stella, Blue Moon, and a two chocolate stout. It's very nice. But yeah, let's walk around here and see what else we can take a look at. Here's the other side. Again, more screens up at the top. Big old benches right here, all the way across. And we gotta have the comfy test. Let me know if it's comfy. Yes?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's comfy. So, very nice. Everything looks very elegant in here. And then check this out. They even have neat little mementos in here. Like bats. So we have metal bats right there. That is neat stuff. Beautiful and elegant Edison bulbs. Just to add to the really nice steampunk lighting in here. So just outside of this area where you actually have all the dining, we have a wide open view of the kitchen, and it is perfectly clean, looks beautiful, state of the art, and they look like they are getting ready for dinner service, which is starting at 4 p.m. But again, top notch, very clean, very open design, and I'm sure the chefs are going to enjoy being able to have that design openness right here. So we covered the downstairs portion. It is now time to head upstairs. You ready, Brandon?
I'm ready.
Let's go.
Let's climb.
So even the stairs here are themed, so you can actually see.
It's like air vents.
Yeah, air vents. They put attention to detail literally everywhere inside this place. The walls here, and you know what? I smell paint. I mean, it is fresh paint.
Yep.
So, I mean, this is opening day. Anything. Yeah, don't lean against anything. Don't touch too many things. Even the railing, I'm a little afraid, but this is the upstairs, and wow.
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 This is amazing.
Check this place out, guys. They have video screens over here with that steampunk look.
Cogs everywhere.
Cogs everywhere. Tables themselves, simple, elegant, but look at the chair itself. Look at that.
And it's
embroidered almost, yeah.
Well, it's tooled, it's leather.
Yeah.
That's leather tooling. I love this part right here.
Yeah. In the words of John Hammond, spared no expense. Yeah, of course, we can look down into the other dining area. Very neat. music playing is kind of tranquil.
Yeah, I don't know, it's very fancy.
Fancy.
It's fancy, pinky finger fancy.
Yeah, I feel ritzy right now.
Yeah.
Even though this place is not for the ultra rich.
No.
Your average Joe like myself and Brandon, we can afford dinner here.
Yeah, prices are very affordable.
Yeah.
Can't go wrong.
Even the salt shakers,
salt and pepper,
looks like they've been mildly used.
Yeah. Well, they did have employee previews. So we are not the first official people. Check out this booth. Tell me if it does it pass the comfy test.
Comfy. I sink in.
You sink in?
I'm sinking.
Okay. I'm gonna sit here as well.
It feels like they've been used.
Yeah, they're like, broken in a bit.
Like they've been.
Yeah, it's been broken in, but this is a big booth. You can fit probably 6-7 people here.
Yep.
Very nice.
Family dinner, right?
Yeah, family dinner. And we'll walk around for the grand tour of the upstairs.
The globe lamps are incredible.
Yeah.
And they have Edison lamps in there too, so.
And then check this out. Something that I noticed even over in this area. They have almost like drainage pipes.
Yeah.
See, again, steampunk feel going all the way around. More of the screens over here. Extending all the way down. Speaker systems. Very nice. And it's not too loud.
No.
And I expect it's gonna be pretty loud in here when this is fully, you know, filled with people.
Yeah.
But as of right now, it's not too loud with the music.
No.
We have the elevator here, which as you can see, that's a glass elevator. Interesting. And restrooms we have right here. So there are upstairs restrooms as well as downstairs. I'll look down over to where the staircase was where we first were.
Look at those lights. They're the fiber optics and stuff. That's unique.
Yeah.
They're like flickering. It's like fireflies.
That is neat. I zoomed in right here so we can actually get a nice view of that. It is almost like fireflies with fiber optics. That's really impressive. And then we have over in this area, let's see what we got. This is almost like an upstairs apartment kind of thing.
Got maps, telescopes.
Yeah. So this is what I would assume would be Penelope's area.
Yeah.
We have a desk over here with some designs and ideas.
Shopping list, and it looks like the formula for cocoa.
It's the formula for fun. Mm-hmm. That's what it is. Telescopes right over there. We'll walk down just a little bit over here. Bookcase with the hats. Well, we do have a robot here somewhere. Chuck is. He should be here a little bit later. But I'm gonna assume this is Penelope's area. And there's the staircase that we saw downstairs earlier.
Yep.
And again, this area looks really nice. So let's move on. Let's check out the bar. I like to have a drink or two, so I want to see what we got available let's over here. And it's about 1 o'clock in the afternoon right here. So you can actually see the sun shining in. I love this, man. More speakers. We do have some art on the wall here with photos. I would assume of maybe Penelope's friends, family, things like that, possibly. Again, steampunk continues all the way around here. And then check out the bar, guys. Big, wide open bar, stools themselves. They do rotate, but they don't spin.
The pedestal, it's the pedestal, attention to detail.
Attention to detail on the pedestal, again.
They almost look like lampposts.
Yeah, and of course, give me the comfy test. Let me know if it's comfy. Because if we're going to be sitting here during Halloween Horror Nights and other nights,
yeah.
I want to know if I'm going to be able
comfy,
to sit.
And not only does it comfy, it passes the spin test too.
So it does pass the spin test. They have all the glassware over here. For your martinis, cocktails, highballs.
Don't forget the old fashions.
Yeah, old fashions again here. Here's that look at the fiber optic lights. That's so neat. Let's check out over here as well. They do have beer on tap. What do we have? Oh yeah. Blue Moon, Stella. What is this? Two chocolate stout. That's got to be pretty awesome, I think.
Worth a try.
Guinness. So again, beer on tap.
Two hearted ale.
Yep. And then check this out. This is the view of City Walk that you get. So as you're enjoying dinner, you get a nice view of everything out here. Islands right over there.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say this might be the best view of City Walk.
I'm gonna agree with you on that one, honestly. And I'm thinking at night when people are leaving the park.
The lights, just having watching everyone funnel out. It's gonna be a nice view, especially when you're sitting up here.
Yeah. So and then let's continue on our tour. Again, there's a lot of bar seats over here. So a lot of room for people. More photos on the wall.
And we have a lot of trinkets up here too.
Yes. Hats.
Clocks. Crows.
I've noticed there's a lot of animals in here.
Yeah.
So it's there's almost like an animal connection here as well. And then, what is this over here? So we have a map.
Map of China.
China. And I wonder if that plays any significance. I really do. I'd like to get maybe a backstory on it, you think?
Yeah.
I would hope that there's some involvement in there.
Yeah.
And then there's more maps over here.
Well, we know Penelope does a lot of world travels.
Yes.
So that might just be from her...
Her travels, yeah. Germania. See there? And then off to the side over here, more trinkets.
More animals.
Yeah, again, more animals. Birds. And then check this out. Look at the different metalwork.
Wow.
So they've got like a lizard.
Made out of like bike chain.
Yeah, bike chain, screws, the dog, cats. Look at the spark plug. Spark plug.
Awesome.
And then really cool. They have these bugs down here. These guys have a little bit more detail. They have a lot of cogs on them, things like that.
That fits in very well in Florida.
Yes. Bunny rabbits, clocks, and there's what looks to be like chocolate molds. See?
Yeah.
I think those would be like chocolate molds.
Yeah, they had some downstairs also.
Whoa. That thing is cool. Check out that mask. Can you imagine having that at Mardi Gras?
That would be fun. And then that
the bulbs.
That lamp bulb is really neat.
Bulbs all over. Again, birds and everything. And that's pretty much it for the upstairs. Except for over here, we do have a boat. Again, more bugs, insects, all over the place. And then I'm thinking this is almost like a private dining area. So this may be like a specialty thing where you can reserve an entire section just for a large party kind of thing.
I like this part. Mexico or New Spain? They weren't too sure.
Yeah, Mexico or New Spain. But I think a lot of this has to do, this is supposed to be steampunk. So we're talking early 1900s kind of thing.
And we know she has a dirigible.
Yeah.
This is probably from her travels.
Yeah, and so they've actually made the pieces time appropriate.
Yeah.
So we have Africa over here. We have the Indian Ocean.
Well, like right here, this part is not explored.
Yeah, it's not even filled in. So definitely.
And past Louisiana, it's.
Look, New France. This is crazy. The attention to detail.
The history buff in me has like.
You just got chills.
I'm getting chills here. This is awesome.
I gotta say, that was really neat though. I'm glad that we got a chance to check out the upstairs. And we're gonna check out some other stuff.
Alright, so we are in the elevator now, and it is a glass elevator, and it's a little wonky in here. That's all I'm going to say. But yeah, it is a nice glass elevator.
More.
There is a magical talking voice. And here we are, going exiting.
Out. Take care.
We were expecting you.
So there is Jacques in the flesh, or excuse me, in the metal.
We are on our way up. We have this lovely lady right here with our menus, and we are heading upstairs for dinner service. Brandon, it's gonna be good, I think.
I'm excited.
Yeah, I'm super excited for this.
I'm glad you're gonna love the food. It's delicious.
So it is hopping up here, super busy right now. And I see our table right over there. Sure enough, that is our table. Brandon, assume the throne. And thank you, miss. And here it is, guys. The Toothsome Chocolate Emporium food and drinks menu. And I gotta say, this is one of the nicest menus I have ever seen. It is a damn book for sure. It is literally a book.
Yeah.
So we have inside here a little story that starts out, and I don't know if I should be the storyteller or not, but I think I'm gonna go ahead. So Jacques landed the dirigible in front of the small cottage home in London, England. Professor Dr. Penelope Tibiax Tinker Toothsome was overjoyed to share her experiences and experiments with her family. She quickly stepped from the cockpit of the airship and dashed up the cobble pathway. She threw open the door, soaking in her childhood home, except it was empty. All that remained was the old Victrola in the corner of the living room. And then we have Penelope stepped in her mother's kitchen, recalling for the first time she ever tasted chocolate. There was a song in her head. She couldn't recall the name of it, but it was French and jazzy. There on the kitchen floor was a note from her parents. Dearest Penelope, we have set out to join you in your adventures. Surely the world isn't so big that we can't find you. We shall look for you wherever chocolate can be found. Love, Thomas and Violet Toothsome. And it says here, Penelope knew immediately what she had to do. She would take everything she knew about chocolate and develop a fully industrialized, state-of-the-art chocolate emporium. Until the day she returned, she was reunited with her family, she would share her love and knowledge of chocolate with the world. With the old Victrola in her arms, Penelope made her way back to the dirigible. Jacques quickly lifted them into the air, and they are off to chase their destiny and find the perfect location for the world's foremost chocolate emporium. There would still be discoveries to be made, but she was determined to make them all. That is the story of Professor Dr. Penelope Tibiax Tinker Toothsome, or at least so I've been told. So after that mouthful and that little backstory, now we get into the different drinks. So we have libations, and a couple things that I want to show you is a lot of the things on here are old fashioned, and the prices aren't too bad. So you can pretty much find those anywhere, at any place, like Cheesecake Factory, NBC Sports, Grill Brew, doesn't matter. Pretty much the same prices, but we have Violet Stream, Wicked Cherry. I'm seeing a lot of different things with cherry in here. So Cell AZ85, Peach Smash, Chocolate Cherry Mule, Vanilla Chocolate Cocktail, Macadamia Chocolate Cherry. Then we have the Neat, which is, you have all sorts of Bolton, Booker's, Scotch, they have all sorts of others. More libations on this side. Smooth and Easy, we have Red Breast 12, Single Pot Still. Again, price is $16 for the flights, not too bad. Then they have the draft beers, which is Guinness, the two chocolate stout, which from what we've been told you cannot find anywhere else, and apparently is very good. I have not tried it yet, I would like to eventually. Then of course you can get your normal bottles, Goose Island, Corona, Bud Light, Budweiser, that kind of stuff, so of course. Then on our next one, we have the potent portables. So you have your bourbon, scotch, rye, moonshine, whiskey, vodka, tequila, and check this. We actually got some appetizers right here.
Warm chocolate almond bread with a salt.
Warm chocolate almond bread.
And what is this over here?
Tachos.
Tachos. That looks absolutely
that
amazing.
Looks amazing.
So, yeah.
Amazing. Here, give me one of those. Give it to me.
Boom.
Warm. Very good. Cheese is amazing.
Yeah, it's like a queso cheese.
Yeah, queso cheese. Very good. So while I let Brandon indulge in our appetizer, we're going to go back to the menu here. So we have gin, rum, cordials, wine. They have a bunch of different wine selections. Reds, whites. Then we have the temptations, which is the appetizers. And that is the one that we got. The warm chocolate almond bread. That beautiful thing right there. Truffle fries, Philly cheesesteak rolls, oh my god. Pork belly sliders, tachos, which is what we got. So for $10.50, look at all you get there. That looks absolutely amazing. We have on the other side of the temptations here, pistachio hummus, kettle chip nachos, which sounds absolutely amazing. Roasted Brussels sprouts, coffee and chocolate stout chicken wings. Amazing. Baked brie, black and tan onion rings with a chocolate ranch dipping sauce. Amazing sounding. That's, I think, one that we're going to have to try eventually.
I think so.
Yeah, I think we're going to have to try that. And then, of course, we have our soups and salads. They have ones with tuna, Asian-inspired shrimp, another Caesar salad, kind of funny, superfoods, French onion soup, then flatbreads. Check out the selection of flatbreads here. Again, prices, not bad. And remember, you get a discount with your annual pass. So we have barbecue chicken, four cheese, blackened steak and blue, forest mushroom, duck, artichoke, classic margarita, and pepperoni. So absolutely amazing there. Sandwiches. So we had red Reuben, croque monsieur, southern fried chicken BLT, vegetable press, fork and knife grilled ribeye steak sandwiches, and grilled Gulf Coast mahi. Amazing. Now here comes the big guys, the hamburgers. And Brandon already ordered one. I ordered something as well. We are getting this one right over here, which is the blue plate burger, which as you can see, has a patty, has mashed potatoes, meatloaf. Amazing. I can't wait to see it when it finally comes out. And let's see, we have may contain bacon, which I think would contain bacon, maybe. And then fork and knife. Pop It Up is the other one that we got, so that one should be pretty amazing. I'm excited for that one. Cheddar bacon burger. That's the hamburgers that we have. Different pastas. Of course, you can get your regular fettuccine alfredo. And then all the other specialty ones with pork belly, mushrooms, stuff like that. Our main entrees over here, we do have a New York strip, which is $46.95, which is not a bad price. Again, pretty standard. If you go to Cheesecake Factory or something like that, you're gonna be spending about the same amount of money. So we have teriyaki salmon, fire grilled pork chops, filet mignons, wild mushroom meatloaf, and brisket. They do have a brunch option, which has crepes, quiche, apple pies, Nutella and banana, ham, berries and cream, Boston cream pie. Then we have waffles, French toast, of course, berries and cream, bananas and Nutella, that kind of stuff. And then come the milkshakes. If you've seen our other video, of course, you would already know what kind of milkshakes that we have. But just as a refresher, we have peanut indulgence, red velvet, salted dulce de leche, marshmallow crisp, which is what we had earlier. And we also had that salted dulce de leche as well. So both of those, heavenly hazelnut, strawberry cheesecake. Then over here, we have some of the sundaes and stuff like that. Chocolate banana brain freeze with that one. Brownie, bacon brittle. Espresso buzz. Key lime pie, which I heard is absolutely incredible. Chocolate times five, cinnamon fantasy. Again, amazing shakes. And then here's the sundaes actually. So may contain nuts, salted caramel flan, banana cream pie, strawberry shortcake. Absolutely amazing. Chocolate brownie bark. Rookies, cookies and cream, excuse me on that one. And cream puff and eclair, s'mores. That s'mores one looks absolutely amazing.
Yeah, I can't wait to get that one.
Yeah, that's gonna be one that I think I really wanna try. And then on our last page of the menu that we have here for desserts, of course we have the triple chocolate bread pudding. We have chocolate cream pie. potted chocolate cream, chocolate creme brulee, which has a cog on it. If I was going to get something from this page, I think I would get that one. And then, of course, they have a classic French chocolate mousse. So that right there, ladies and gentlemen, is our Toothsome chocolate menu, and we are about to dig in on our appetizer right now. So again, everything here, spared no expense, and even the fork and knives are hammered. Very nice, very unique, and I think it's time to dig in. Let's dig in on this. So I wanted to take a quick second and talk about the bread that we got here. This is only $2.95, and you got a huge loaf, but look at the chocolate inside of that thing. And of course, it comes with this butter over here that is almost like a caramel kind of taste to it. And I think this is absolutely phenomenal. What are your thoughts on it?
Two thumbs up. The whole thing about chocolate and bread, knowing that it is bread, having that chocolate, your mind can't wrap around it. It has that chocolate aftertaste, but it has the texture of bread. Not so much cake, but bread. It's really good.
Yeah, I gotta fully agree with this. It's soft, it's warm, the butter melts on it, and it is beyond delicious.
Ladies and gentlemen, dinner has arrived, and we have amazing burgers. Look at the size of that thing. It's got the mashed potatoes, meatloaf on the very top. The chips look very fresh. And this is the Pub It Up burger. And fries look fantastic as well. And we're gonna try this right now.
Alrighty, Brandon, it is the moment of truth. Our entree is here, and we got, of course, both of our burgers. We split them up so that we can both try it out. Go ahead and try your first bite.
All right, so.
And you're gonna do the blue collar one, it looks like.
Blue plate.
Blue plate.
So, you got your meat, your mashed potatoes, your meatloaf, and there's, I believe, some sort of sauce. I'm not too sure what it is, but it looks amazing.
As your face lights up, and don't talk with your mouth full, that's not appropriate. Chew!
That's amazing. Mashed potatoes on a burger. First of all, that's an amazing idea, let alone. The meatloaf, though, wow. And whatever sauce is on there, I can't pronounce it. It tastes incredible, absolutely incredible.
All right, so of course, next one is gonna be the Pub It Up.
Yes, and I love pretzel buns, so you got a pretzel bun, you got kettle chips, and then you have some sort of cheese on there, and then your meat, so let's give it a shot.
Now, which one do you like better? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. So, let me try. It is actually my turn now, so I'm gonna pass this off to you. And I'm gonna try this one first. Since you said you like the other one better, I'm gonna try this one again. Beautifully cooked, we got medium on it, and it looks beautiful, not overdone. Pretzel bun is actually pretty soft, which is nice, and here we go. Bun is very soft, really good kind of smoked flavor to the meat. It's very good.
And then we have over here the blue plate special. Look at all that mashed potato. It just overtakes the entire thing.
But I like the barbecue sauce. Generally, I like barbecue, so.
I don't think it's a barbecue sauce, so it's a little different than that, but it's really good nonetheless.
Okay, so here we go. It's probably gonna be a little messy.
And as it comes out of the bun.
Holy. I'm sorry, but the mashed potato is amazing. Again, that adds so much to it. But the meatloaf is the real winner here.
Yeah.
You get the great taste of the burger, but then you get the other different variable with the meatloaf. And what meatloaf normally is, this is right up there with the best of the best. It's beyond amazing. I don't know what to say, other than we're just gonna chill and pig out. So, bye. So there we have Miss Penelope Toothsome right there.
Hello there.
Hello there. My name is Daniel. This is Brandon.
I've heard a lot about your world travels.
Oh, yes, I do.
love to travel around the world. It's lovely to have you all here.
Thank you for having us. Oh, you look absolutely stunning, madam.
Oh, thank you very much. I got this in Paris.
In Paris?
I don't remember quite when. Time travel will do that.
Okay.
But I did get it in Paris.
Very nice.
Well, my dirigible sometimes lands in places that there are in other times. Yes.
Gotcha.
Yes. Have you ever traveled by dirigible?
No, actually.
No, oh, you should try it. It's quite lovely.
It's like a something.
Yes, almost. Like a flying machine.
Very
my
nice.
My father built mine for me, though. It's very special.
I saw Jacques was around here as well, your companion.
Oh, my
He's
best
lovely
friend.
As well.
Oh, thank you. My father built it for me as well.
Very nice.
That's where the Tinker in Tinker Toothsome comes from.
Ah, fantastic. Sense. That does make sense on
yes,
here.
My father was an inventor.
I have to ask.
Yes.
I see a lot of these. What are these?
Oh. You must know. You must always have extra ingredients when working in a kitchen, right?
Hmm.
So I always have pepper. And then
very smart.
Cocoa powder, and of course chocolate sprinkles.
Wow.
Always have chocolate with you on your travels.
Absolutely.
Trust me, our dirigible once crashed in the jungles of Madagascar, and a group of tribal warriors was going to eat me until
that's not good.
I shared my chocolate, and they chose that instead.
You know, and I also hear eating chocolate is a great stress reliever, so whenever you're stressed, bring the chocolate.
Maybe that's why I'm never stressed. I eat chocolate all the time.
I ran into Jacques earlier, and he was telling me, we were talking about our milkshakes earlier.
Oh, yes.
And I was a little bit stressed out because, like, it has zero calories.
Yeah. Oh, calories don't matter. And chocolate is a vegetable. It comes from a bean. Yeah. Absolutely.
I love it.
Very simple.
He was basically saying it's healthy.
Oh, absolutely.
That's good to know.
Oh, yeah. I would live on chocolate alone if I could.
Yeah.
I found it's not the best idea. But see, you found something else. Love on tacos.
They're amazing.
They are amazing.
Absolutely amazing. And I really like the bread because you get chocolate.
Yes.
So, of course.
Chocolate at the beginning of the meal and beer.
Is
of course.
Recipe?
It is my recipe. Oh, yes, I have it. The chocolate was my idea.
Yeah.
As always.
Penelope, we know you're a very busy gal and you got to get around, so thank you so much for at least stopping by and saying hi.
It's all right.
Thank you.
So if you guys were interested about these sliders, well, there you have it right there. Those are the pork belly sliders. We also have some pasta as well, and look at the size of that burger right there.
That may contain bacon.
May contain bacon, and thank you guys so much for actually showing this. I hope you guys are enjoying it.
We are.
Hello again. You found Jacques though. So you found him. You guys have been everywhere today. It's been wonderful. Everywhere.
We just got it. I had a little bit of the chips and they are so good.
Yeah, fries are good as well. Burger, everything looks great portion wise. Yes, it's a big burger. It's beautiful. Well guys, that is going to do it for our Toothsome Chocolate Emporium and Savory Feast Kitchen video. It was absolutely incredible. From earlier in the day when we got to try the milkshakes to our appetizers main entree, the service from Felicia was absolutely incredible. Our server managers were awesome. Bar was incredible. Jacques and Penelope were great. Absolutely fantastic. I cannot speak highly enough about this place. And of course, I'm going to be here many more times. So if you like what we do, follow us on Instagram, our Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Midway Mayhem. And I'll see you out on the Midway.